What's up? What's good? If you missed my video this morning, I said happy Thanksgiving. Happy early Thanksgiving to those of you who celebrate. Today is the day that we are going to dive right into the time machine. Now, you may have heard the time machine before, but this is something that I use every single day that allows me to automate and be productive and save time and not have to type the same thing a million times. Now, if you missed video number one, which I did live, you are first for the time machine, and this is totally free what I'm about to show you. First, gonna go over to phraseexpress.com, as you can see right up here in my browser, and you're gonna go to download, and then you have to choose your respective one. So for me, it's going to be Windows, and I use the first one, which is the Phrase Express client, but you can use the portable edition, and there's also the Phrase Express server. So I'm going to assume that you did see my video and you already downloaded it by clicking on this button right here, accepting the terms and clicking on Phrase Express Client. Now, the one from Mac is a little bit different, but acts the same way. So we are using the Windows version. All right, so I already have this installed. Like I said, I use this every single day. But if you don't know what the time machine is, you can very simply go over to my channel, which is youtube.com/expertcreditsweeps, type in time machine, and it's going to allow you to see the original videos about the time machine. So time machine. Now we have a couple of them. Time machine, get back your time and money, world's first time machine webinar Saturday, and so on and so forth. There's a handful of them on here, but all of these are going to allow you to understand how to create a dispute letter in just 5 seconds. Now, it's not just creating a dispute letter. I can send out, make my computer, in other words, automatically send out text, emails, initiate phone calls. I can automate tons and tons of stuff, import data. I can work with the data. So anyways, first thing is I'm going to show you a couple of very simple things. Now, you can even create your own credit repair software. And that is the premise of this video and this workshop. This is, like I said, video number two. So we've already installed it. Go and install it. Now I'm going to show you what to do. Okay. So very first thing is that you need to set up a couple of things inside of Phrase Express. Now, pausing there for 2 seconds. Phrase Express is free for personal use. If Phrase Express determines that you are not using it for personal but for business, it's going to give you a little reminder now and then to upgrade to one of their paid license. But obviously, it can't force you, and it doesn't really know if for certain you really are using it for business purposes. Okay, so anywho, I have a ton of different videos here. I have a bunch of links, and I am going to, at the end of this workshop, for you to access yourself, I'm going to allow you to download this, okay? Now, there's a couple of things that I will be offering, but we're not going to get there just yet. First thing that you're going to want to do, once you have installed Phrase Express, is you're going to go and you're going to create a folder. Call it whatever you want. I have called mine Time Machine, okay? So first I'm gonna show you how to set this up, and then I'm gonna show you what you can do. And don't jump the gun and, you know, skip through this video. You need to watch this from start to finish if you wanna know how to use this the right way, okay? So I called mine Time Machine. What I did was I clicked on local phrase file. I went to create folder, and I said Time Machine, and this is going to be demo. And I want to choose for all of these to be after manual confirmation, and that means typing in the enter button, okay? Now you can set it to whatever you want, but I'm making this as simple as possible for you. So go and click on Time Machine, and now you're going to add a new folder, okay? Now I already have all of mine made. I'm just showing you how to do this. So you would go and click here, and then you could do again, new folder, and this would be new folder. I'm going to call this two, and I want for all of mine to be manual execution. So I'm going to bulk edit, and you can actually auto text to manual confirmation. Okay. So anyways, we're going to skip past that. I'm going to show you what you can do with this. So Time Machine, I have emails set up here. I have a CRM set up. I have a sample client in there, and I'm gonna show you how to do all this stuff. This is a series though. Okay. And I am creating a playlist for this. Create a dispute letter. I'm going to show you how to create a dispute letter to the bureaus, as well as to a collector using the validation of debt letter. And then I have client disputed accounts. I have Jane Doe inquiries and Jane Doe accounts. I have my letters, And we have quite a few in here. Accounts included in bankruptcy, letter six, how was it verified, blah, blah, blah. And then I have my validation of debt letters. And I have a reminders folder as well as credit bureaus and creditors. I have a sample creditor and then I have my three bureaus as well as dispute reasons. And I have a hoard, meaning hundreds of dispute reasons in here that I use every single day, okay? So now, what is the entire point of using this? Well, I'm going to show you very simply what can be accomplished. Now, I added myself as a client in my own client dispute manager account. As a client here, I added some accounts, I added the bureaus, blah, blah, blah. And now, instead of manually typing in everything that I do, I can very simply, using everything that I have set up in Phrase Express, make it so that I save a ton of time. So let me show you an example. So let's go choose a letter, initial dispute, and I'm going to put a custom reason. So let's say that I'm disputing this collection with a firm. I'm actually going to use probably a dispute reason having to do with a charge off just because of who they are. So I have a full dispute reason saved as COF1. Now, as you can see, charge off one shows up and I'm gonna tab. And that full dispute reason just showed up. Add dispute. So instead of going and typing out, you reported different dates under date of last activity, da 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 da. All I did was put in four letters, COF1. Well, four characters, And I hit tab, and that full thing showed up. Now, if you can imagine, this would make it significantly faster and more productive for you. So here's another example. I have a full dispute letter saved as independent investigation. So let's go and independent investigation. As you can see, it shows up. Now, that full dispute letter shows up. So this is going to be right under. This is personal information. Here is the date and the credit bureau. So this is actually where it would go, and you can even put, dear Credit Bureau or dear Equifax or dear, TransUnion or whatever you want to do. Now, speaking of the bureau names, I have those saved as well. So if I wanted to put in Experian, I have that saved. If I want to put in Equifax, I have that saved. If I want to put in TransUnion, I have that saved. As you can see, this makes it significantly easier. Now, let's say that I'm disputing American Express account 349992. This is a charge off, so let's go and do charge off round one version A. Now, this is a totally different dispute reason. Account reports different dates under date of last payment. How is this possible? Stop reporting this due to FCRA non-compliance of inaccurate data being furnished on the consumer report. Now, this is actually where I would put the facts and I would put the difference between these three dates. This is how factual based disputes work. Okay, so now I put in all of my accounts and I'm just going to say, send me a new credit report. Thank you. And then name, right? So here is another example. I actually have a full dispute letter saved. Now let's go pull up the time machine again. In other words, Phrase Express. And I just clicked on the wrong thing, so just give me 2 seconds. Here we go. So I have, as you can see, all of these dispute reasons are saved in my system, right? So we're going to go and we're going to look at create a dispute letter. If I click on the arrow, I'm going to go to dispute letter template. And this was created by, I'm going to show you right here. I created this by going and doing some user inputs, manual text. I also did this by using the document generator where I pull my clients from the client folder, the client accounts from the client accounts folder, and my dispute reasons from the dispute reason folder. And you're gonna see what this looks like. So my auto text, which is what kind of like the COF1, is what I type in to initiate this. So create dispute letter. As you can see, this initiates it. Type full name, Kristen Vargas. Okay. Now it automatically enters today's date. Now I have a sample client and they're literally called sample client. Okay. So this would obviously be their actual first, last name, date of birth, address, social. Now I need to choose whether I want to do a letter to one of the bureaus or a sample creditor. I'm going to choose Experian and it automatically adds an Experian. And as you can see, this actually walks you through step by step, right? So do I want to do a validation of debt letter? No, I want to use a simple dispute letter to the bureaus. And we are going to, I think, is this a tab? Okay, so now when I hover over this, it's going to give me all of the letters that I have saved in here. We're going to go with Credit Bureau Verified A. Let's go with How Was It Verified B. As you can see, the text showed up automatically. Now I'm going to go and choose one of the client accounts that I have saved in here. So let's just pretend that the sample client was Jane Doe. So I have Jane Doe accounts and Jane Doe inquiries. I'm going to go and do Jane Doe accounts. And obviously I put my name because that's the name that I typed in initially when it showed up. So I'm going to show you the only other thing that you have to do now is go and add your dispute reasons in, right? So we have a different type of charge off one. We have, let's say that this is charge off 1A. Let's do this one as charge off 1C. And that is the entire dispute letter. And this is going to be Jane Doe. And this is going to be Jane Doe. So all I did was just correct that a little bit. Okay, so this is literally the easiest thing that you can possibly utilize to automate your dispute process. Not only that, but like I said, this allows you to create a full and complete credit repair software. And again, this is a series, so I'm just introducing you to this, showing what can be done. And then we're gonna go step by step and create each section of this, and I'm gonna show you exactly what can be done with this. Now, let's say that, another thing that can be done is you can use Phrase Express and the Time Machine in any browser window. So let's say that, let me go and show you actually. So let's go back to Phrase Express and I'm going to do a test. Let me go to my test process. Okay, so I have a test process that I created in here, right? And I can choose to, let's just create a new one, new phrase. So your phrase is going to be your automations. So I can just name this as a Google test. Now that I clicked inside of the phrase content, I can go and choose what I want. So I can insert stuff like a table, picture, hyperlink. I can use macros, and there's a macro recorder right here that is a separate download. It allows you to basically have ghost fingers on your computer or your PC or your Mac where your computer runs without you doing anything, where you click record, you do whatever you're doing, clicking here, moving that, blah, blah, blah. You stop it and then insert it into a phrase. So we can go and look at automation. We can create an email, open web page, run program, open file, open folder, set application focus, and macro loop. If I go to programming, insert phrase, which is how we built the document, check text against a value, if then else, calculation, wait X milliseconds, such as when a page is loading, set phrase content, set counter value, set variable and output variable. And then we have our text operations. We can paste from the clipboard. We can do, make a box show up as like an alert. We can use external data such as Outlook email, translate text, external document, embed file contents, database query, MS Excel cells, CSV data, find MS Excel column and row, so on and so forth, right? So what we want to do for our Google test is we are going to automate by opening a web page. So when I click on open web page, the URL is going to be https://google.com. And if you were using Internet Explorer, you can wait a specific amount of seconds. I'm not going to. I'm just going to click on OK. Now, I'm going to save this as google.open. And then as you can see, like how I said it before, execute after manual confirmation, okay? So I'm going to save this, control save, and let's go test it. So let's get rid of this letter. And let's just pretend like I'm typing anywhere. Doesn't need to be Word. I just put google.open. And as you can see, it allows me to tab to execute. And there you go. It pulled up google.com. That is a very, very, very simple automation and all I did was save it as what I knew that I would remember. But this is really, really simple and super, super powerful. You can use this in any application, any browser, any window, any software, any platform. Phrase Express literally works everywhere. Okay. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to break this down and set everything up. And what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to create a full-blown webinar, and I'm going to break everything down and show you everything that's possible, show you how to turn this into a credit repair software, and I will also have the videos here on YouTube, like I mentioned, as a playlist. But if you want the start to finish, literally, credit repair software for yourself, then the webinar is what you're going to want to view. And I need to go create it, so the link might not be ready and available yet, but if it is, then it's going to be posted down in the description, right? So I'm super, super excited because you can use this literally on anything. But that is it for right now. I hope you have a wonderful day. I just want to put this out really quick, and I'll see you later.